This is BP40 Lens Tests, and we're here in my studio with Eric Dickinson, our model. We're testing my XELMUS APOLLO 2X Anamorphics. This is the 40mm, which is a maximum aperture of T2 wide open, and the close focus is 16 inches, I believe. Let's go ahead and show them close focus, Eric. A little bit forward more, a little forward more. Yeah, right there. So you can see how amazing close focus is. It's actually 15 inches on this 40mm. So these lenses are famous for their close focus capability. No need for a diopter. And they just have really creamy look with minimal distortion. You could go back, Eric, please. Thank you. So right here, this is wide open. And I'll do this lens test a little bit stopped down. You'll notice that wide open, it's creamy, but you'll see the fall off will get less intense as you stop down. So this is a 2.1, 2.8. It doesn't take a whole lot. Maybe we'll do like a T2.5. That's where we're at right now. Just kind of sharpens up a bit more. I think, you know, they're really cool wide open if you're like really close focus. But as the subject gets further away, I think it's better to stop it down a bit more, as is the case with most anamorphic lenses. But I would say compared to most anamorphic lenses, these are actually really sharp, even wide open. And you'll notice too, when we do the flare test, that the flare characteristics change depending on your aperture. So here we'll do a focus pull from 6 feet here to the minimum, 15 inches. We're gonna roll back slowly through infinity. And you'll see this little Viking character in the background. Right there, I'm focused on him. This is so we can test chromatic aberration. And you'll see these lenses also handle chromatic aberration relatively well. I open it back up again so that you can see the most dramatic effect. But there's really not a lot of color shifting happening. There is some, but it's minimal. Especially for a 2X anamorphic lens wide open like that. So here's, we'll see, like, you'll see if I stop it down, you'll see the aberration cleanup versus wide open. You can see it's kind of, it's almost like a smeary aberration. And then as you stop it down, so like right around there, yeah, it's like, yeah, like right around 2.5 on this lens, it's pretty clean. So I typically shoot these like around 2.5, 2.8, or if it's a further distance, 4, 5, 6 T-stop. But it just depends on what you're looking to do creativity-wise. Next, we'll do a distortion test. So we're just gonna pan, and you'll see these have an anti-mump design. Some anamorphics have the mumps. When you pan, it's almost like wavy looking. These don't do that at all. Very, very low distortion. If anything, it's a slight barrel distortion, but it's very slight. Then we'll do a tilt test. And you'll see, as is the case with most anamorphics, they're not very sharp at the top or bottom edges, or the corners in general. They kind of have a steep focus fall off. But that's also part of the look, to get that creamy fall off. And we'll just do one last like racking quickly so you can see how they breathe. They breathe in the vertical direction only, which is unique and similar to like a Panavision C-series anamorphic. C-series anamorphics and most Panavision, I think all Panavision anamorphics have an anti-stigmatizer inside, so they don't really breathe at all. These breathe in the vertical direction. But it's much nicer than, say, like Atlas Orion, which breathes in all directions in a lot of more budget anamorphics. That's why I got these lenses, because for the money, they perform well above their price for anamorphic lenses. So they're $20,000 per lens, and they can compete with a $40,000 or $50,000 lens. And a lot of people even prefer them, so they get used on a lot of big shows and movies just because of their unique characteristics, from the flares, the close focus, the low distortion. Okay, and we'll do a full aperture test. So we'll go from T2, and we're gonna slowly roll the aperture to the minimum, which is T16. Just so you can see how the bokeh changes. And back to T2. Next, we'll do a flare test. And this is wide open on the lens. You can see a lot of like rainbow concentric ovals. Then you have a lot of orbs. You have a very nice and horizontal classic blue flare. And XELMUS really works hard on their coatings and element design to try to minimize the amount of diagonal flare happening, so it's as horizontal as possible. I think it's the most difficult to achieve on the wider the lens is. So like on this one, you can see a little bit of a diagonal flare, but the brightest parts are horizontal. But yeah, you get nice classic blue, purple, amber colors, lots of nice orbs. Then you'll notice if you stop the lens down, I'm gonna gradually stop it down. You'll see it'll get rid of a lot of that haze contamination. And this is at 5.6. But you still have a nice clean flare with orbs and a nice horizontal blue. And then the other nice thing is it will flare to the color of the source. As we're going to demonstrate with this red light. And it takes a pretty saturated source. It wants to be classic blue, but if you use a saturated source or a pretty bright and saturated source, you'll see the color of the source kind of mixed in with the classic blue. With this being just a pure red light, you're just going to get a red flare. That's like a more of an amber. Is that the amber color, Eric? Yeah, nice. Yeah, you can see he switched this light to a more amber. And this is a good example of how, I'm gonna stop it down some. You kind of get the mix. This is not a super saturated source, so you still get the classic blue, but it's more amber than like the blue source was. Here we are on the XELMUS APOLLO 60mm. This lens is a T16, it's the fastest of the set. Minimum focus is 16 inches. And here we are at T16, and it has a nice, you know, it's pretty sharp on center, but it's quite creamy. I'd say for the test, I would stop it down to a 2.5 again. I feel like the 2.5 is a nice sweet spot right there. So yeah, that's a 2.5. It just gets some better contrast, better color, and yeah, more sharpness. Then go ahead and come to close focus, Eric. A little closer. A little closer. Nice. Try to lower your head, but tilt your head back. There you go, and then come closer. A little closer. Nice. So you can see how dramatic these close-ups you can get right into the eyes. And I'm gonna go wide open here. You can see it gets really creamy. And the bokeh is quite enhanced. You can see the bokeh shrinking in the background. So with these really close-up shots, a lot of DPs like to push it close to wide open or wide open. All right, let's go back, please. And we'll just do some focus breathing tests. You can see, same thing, breathe in the vertical direction. Nice oval bokeh. I'm gonna stop on the Viking warrior right there. We'll take a look at chromatic aberration. So you see it's more of like an aberration, not too chromatic. If anything, it's kind of purplish. Then you can see a lot of those go away, just stopping down a bit to that T2.5 sweet spot, which is right there. I'm gonna stop it all the way down. And go back all the way wide open. So there's T1.6. All the way down to T16. Stop it at T25 again. There it is. And we'll look at our distortion. You can see side to side, they're really sharp. Especially the 60. There's some barrel distortion, but minimal for an anamorphic. But it's nice to see him staying like totally sharp on the edges here. You just can't get that same kind of performance on the top and bottom of the lens, which is typical for a lot of anamorphics. Especially the 2X front anamorphics. So now we're gonna test the top and bottom. Bottom first. And the top. How's that fall off that goes through? Okay, next we'll test the lens flare of the 60 millimeter. Here we go. This lens is a little bit faster, and so this light is set to the same brightness, but it's, you know, appearing brighter because the lens is faster. You can see that this has a lot of rainbow flare attributes, and as I stop it down, you'll see that those will go away at a certain point. Like right there, they're starting to go away. So you still get some. It's a T4.5 right now. So yeah, you know, you can control the flare just by stopping it down and get different looks out of it. If it's not a very bright source, you could be wide open and get some really cool rainbow artifacts. Or like, for example, if you go wide open, I'm gonna go wide open and then like put the source kind of off axis, like kind of out of the lens purview. Like up higher, a little lower, and go out more to the side, lower. You know, you can get stuff like that where you kind of get this nice rainbow edge with some orbs. You can get these nice rainbow hints and real streaky orbs. This is the blue light. You can see how the tungsten changes to the color of the source. And then here's the red. I'm gonna hand this to Eric so it's further away. And you can see when you stop it down, a lot of that rainbow goes away. You can see all the rainbow accents going away. But some of them stay still. But it's just like a little bit. It's like one stop. And you can, but it also gets rid of a lot of the haze. On to the 100 millimeter XELMUS APOLLO 2X Anamorphic. This one is a T2.5 maximum aperture, so it's not as fast, but it is quite sharp, so you know you don't really have to stop this one down like you do the other ones. As you can see, wide open at T2.5 here, it performs very nice. And the minimum focus distance is just inside of 18 inches. So let's show them that, Eric. A little bit back, a little forward. Yeah, a little forward. Yeah. So that is impressive. A little bit forward. There we go. We're looking into your soul. Nice. Okay, and come on back. We'll do a little rack focus test. You can see the nice oval bokeh. And there's very minimal chromatic aberration and onion skinning around these point light sources. Here we're gonna set the focus to the Viking. Right there. Then I say there's like a slight purple fringe, and we'll stop it down. Pretty much gone now at 2.8. And stopping all the way down to T16. Back to the maximum. 2.5. So this is 2.8. I feel like 2.8 is where the chromatic aberration goes away. It just cleans up just a little bit. But it's still quite nice at 2.5. Let's see how Eric looks at 2.8 versus 2.5. So here he is wide open at 2.5. And this is 2.8. This is 4. It's quite sharp, this lens. Let's look at the bokeh, like right in here maybe, and see how the stopping down affects it. Four, 2.8, 2.5. In general, I feel very comfortable using this lens at a 2.5 also. But of course, if you need a deeper depth of field, stop it down. So we'll just do this test at T2.5. All right, so now we'll look at the distortion. Nice and sharp on the edges. This one maybe has the most amount of barrel distortion because you can see how Eric's face gets slimmer as it gets closer to the edges. So it's very minimal in the center, looking good. And he kind of gets squished here, but he stays sharp. Okay, now we'll test the vertical. It's definitely, the 100 millimeter is definitely the sharpest on the top and the bottom. Not so much fall off as with the other lenses. It's a very nice, very clean 100 millimeter 2X anamorphic. One last test to look at the focus breathing. I'm gonna rack back and forth quickly. It might also have the most minimal breathing. It still does it in the vertical direction, but it's not that much of a stretch. XELMUS did a particularly nice job with this 100 millimeter. Next, we'll test the flares. This is wide open at 2.5, getting some rainbow action. It's maybe a little less saturated in the rainbow department. The rainbows are maybe a little more yellow. I'm gonna stop it down some, see if we can get rid of some of the haze contamination. Hold it kind of in the middle. So right here, that is, so that's a T4, gets rid of all the haze. It kind of gets rid of any rainbow, but you do get nice orbs. And this flare, I would say, has more green to it than the other lenses. Definitely has a stronger diagonal streak too. I'd say probably the worst of the three for flare. It's still a good flare, but I think the 40 and the 60, that the 40 millimeter probably has the best flare. Yeah, these orbs are not quite as big. Now let's test the red. I'm gonna go wide open again. Yeah, just a little less orby. Let me try bringing it closer. See if we can get more orbs. Yeah, it tends to reject the orbs more. The 40 has the most orbs than the 60. This is the blue on there. Is the amber. Sure. Try going in the center and just go straight across the middle. Yeah, right there, and just go straight across. And then I'm gonna stop it down to 4. Okay, do it again. That concludes our lens test of the XELMUS Apollo 2X Anamorphics. Contact info@bp40creative.com for rental inquiries.